Good morning.
These little lassie dogs. I know they're not lassie dogs.
What's the matter, puppy? All right, we're back. So here's that night.
All flew over there next door.
I know. She reached out to us this morning that.
I don't think you want to go over there.
Yeah, we're not gonna go over there. Okay, she got the greatest, best thermostat.
That's the one you told me to get.
Honeywell 9000. Absolutely. Beautiful thermostat. And it's replacing this.
Yeah.
I just hope we have enough wires for it.
I didn't touch anything. All right.
Come here, girl.
All right. So.
Come on, puppy.
We got lucky. We have multiple wires here, but most importantly, we need a common wire or a third wire because the red is typically RH, the white is W, and when those two are closed, or those two are together, the circuit is on, and that green wire that's sitting right there, we're gonna make that the common. Hopefully this wire also goes to the boiler. Pop the cover off.
Cover off.
Of the boiler. I already unloosened the screws. All right, and let's take a peek under the hood. Let's kill the power switch, which is right there. And we are lucky. So there is that third wire, the green. All right, so I connected the green wire, which we made C, to the C terminal, the common terminal. You can notice that the red is on R and the white is on W. We're gonna make that change on the new thermostat. Working across the street.
7 o'clock, sometimes 5:30.
Mm-hmm. Is that legal?
No.
No.
Oh. 7 is legal, 5:30 is
legal. Do they give you like a payout or nothing?
They didn't give me shit.
Really?
Yeah.
Why not?
Well, I got a lawyer and everything. And yeah. You know, it got to a point where I was getting more aggravated than it was worth. You know, Mike?
I hear you.
So.
Well, I just cooperate.
And you're dealing with the MTA. And we don't want to hear shit. They had some lady calling me, sending me letters, and all this other shit. I was like, just leave me the fuck alone.
Oh, I would have made a big stink until they paid me.
Yeah, I mean, I have someone in the... You know, in the lawyer industry, he was actually in Queens Supreme Court.
Oh.
She wanted me to get somebody, but then they would have had to put in for a stop work order over here, and
I just want them done.
You know what I mean?
I hear you.
I don't think I was going to get much out of it, anything, you know?
You never know.
Yeah.
But you're right. But that is a big, giant thing to build. Oh, you don't... Oh, you, oh.
And it's useless. It's a useless waste of money. You know? They should have used that money and put bulkheads at the end of each block.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yep. Give us a little protection from the water. No.
So, I recently learned that you live in Hamilton Beach.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And we actually, before we pulled up to your house today, we was like, you know, we'll take this to the end of the block. And that's the end of the block right there. And Hamilton Beach is a national park.
Yeah.
Wow. Like, okay, so what is the significance of this Hamilton Beach?
Nothing.
Okay.
We don't even have a zip code.
It's part of Howard Beach,
Howard,
right?
Beach or Jamaica.
Oh, yeah, Jamaica.
So at one point, there was West Hamilton Beach.
Yes.
And on the other side of the tracks was East Hamilton Beach.
On the other side of the tracks?
Yeah, that's the A train, right?
Yeah, I know, yeah.
So on the other
side... How do you get to the other side of the tracks?
You can't anymore.
Huh.
It's all blocked off. You used to go through Lefferts Boulevard.
Yeah.
So there's a canal that goes through there called Bergen Basin over there.
So there's houses over there?
You believe?
Yeah.
Who is?
Nah, I had my cut reopened.
What are you doing? You're oozing over the floor.
In a video.
So oh my God. Well, go catch yourself up.
I didn't know about the wires.
Fix my hand.
Want to do wires? Right. Good that he had the right wires.
Yeah, we're lucky.
Yeah.
We're lucky that the wires are good. So, and we're also lucky that there's a... Oh, man, I felt like there was something there. You know what? We'll have to get like a long sheetrock, a longer sheetrock.
I might have. You have?
Yeah. We'll send Derek to the truck.
I always save shit in the drawer here.
So there's that.
It's any longer than you got or it's too big?
No, I need something a little...
Wider.
No, the head is a little different. A little bit different. All right, so there's that.
Let's get our little torpedo. We're gonna tighten this up.
Busy the last couple of days, right?
Yeah, a little bit. Okay, so we need to raise up this side a little bit. You know, some of these thermostat bases, they come with built-in, little levels, and they never really work. No. So what's great about the Honeywell 9000 is that as long as you have a C wire, we can remotely monitor and control the heating, because it's a heating only here though, in your whole house. So you could be in Florida, for example, get a notification that, hey, the house dropped below a certain set point, something's wrong, maybe call a friend, family member, neighbor, call the HVAC contractor, see what's going on. Exactly. So, and a lot of the Wi-Fi thermostats do that. Nest is a very popular one. Ecobee is another. But as a professional, the Honeywell 9000 is by far the best thermostat on the market, by far. And I installed it on my investment properties so I can remotely monitor as long as there's Wi-Fi there. My house, I have all of them. They're amazing. They really are amazing. So.
Where do you have investment properties? In Florida?
Long Island, no. Multifamily, houses, because I don't have the luxury of working for a Fortune 500 company with a nice big fat 401k or stock options, right? Yeah. So my only retirement is going to be A, if I sell my company to private equity, or B, a key man employee takes over, or, rental income.
There you go, key man employee.
Nah, Daniel.
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 Oh,
Daniel. Yeah, Daniel.
Oh, that's the other kid in the video?
The manager.
He looks kind of young.
He is young.
Oh, he's like
26.
And he owns his own property.
Oh, cool.
And which I made him do.
Well, the first one I saw with the videos, with the Alta, because I was like,
yes.
I got to get somebody that knows about this shit. Because...
So the Daniel also has his own YouTube channel, DCHVAC.
Oh, wow.
And he found us on YouTube before. That's how he started working for the company, because he saw the work that we were doing. And
All right. How many guys do you have? You have a lot of guys.
Derek, me, Daniel, Carlos, Janine.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
All right, so now, come on in, because no one's really going to see anything over there. We have R, we have C on the top, and W in the top right-hand corner.
Mm-hmm. R. Uncommon.
And they just slide right in there. Now, we're going to turn the switch on to the boiler. We heard it do something right now. And now, I'm going to take that base plate. And voila. Or not. All right. While you're not coming on, let's make sure that we are good there. Hopefully that was all the way in. Now, if this doesn't work, we're going to need to check our wiring. Hopefully there's not a break in the wire between point A to point B. So this thermostat is not powering up. So next we're gonna do is pull this off the wall. Let's turn the boiler back off. Let's carefully remove the wiring. So there's that common wire. Here is the red wire, right? So now let's get our voltmeter and check for 24 volts. Turn the power back on. All right, let's check to see if we have voltage here. If we have voltage here, we have bad thermostat. We have no voltage
no
there.
Voltage.
All right, we're at the boiler. Let's turn the boiler back on. Give me that. Put that like right here. All right, R and C.
R and C. R and C. Okay, very good. What we got?
28
volts. So we have voltage leaving the boiler, but not at the water.
We are in the crawl space, ladies and gentlemen. And there is the splice. Unbelievable. So there's our wiring, the R, the W, and the green is going to be RC. So let's wire nut that together and be on our way.
Two, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get the common and the R. R, by the way, is 24 volts. That's in there. Now, turn the boiler on. And in a moment, it'll say Honeywell. There you go. Look at that. Next part of the video, we're going to connect to Wi-Fi. Stick around. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button and subscribe.
I was reading. These don't require a common wire then?
Is that this? Why? No. This is more like a...
It's just
very mechanical. It has a control board in there though, but it's mostly operated by like springs to measure thing. But it does have a control board there with a electrical components, resistors, capacitors, but nothing like this. This anything with a display, Wi-Fi, you need to have Wi-Fi. Okay, so English, Frances, or Espanol?
English.
Okay, very good. Now we're gonna call this your home, and we're gonna call this thermostat. What do you have multiple homes, right?
No.
Oh, I thought you live in Florida part of the year.
No, I have a place in Jersey.
Ah. Thermostat does heating only. And it's a hot water system or steam. It is hot water. We have one stage. Saving changes. And next we're going to connect to Wi-Fi. Yes. It's going to think. And now we're going to find the Wi-Fi network and enter in the password. All right. So we successfully connected to the wireless network. And now we're going to use that MAC address and the CRC number to register the account online. Now you have to use a tablet or a computer. You could try to use your smartphone, but I highly recommend using a computer, but let's register it to their account. About this thermostat, I know it says it's set for 70 there, but let's lower it to 68, right? Is that we can remotely control this thermostat. It take a second. I'm also using the web app. There it is. Set for 72, reading 72. It took about 3-4 seconds for that to register, but the Wi-Fi thermostat is now connected to the network. We have the date and time. We have outdoor temperature, outdoor humidity, and this is based off of internet data. Indoor humidity, indoor temperature, that's a local number. So it's 31% humidity right here, and it's reading 69 degrees. It's set for 70. Degrees, we could do a permanent hold and done. So if they want to configure scheduling, it's best to use the app and it'll ask you for, you know, who's home during the day, what time you wake up, what time you come home from work, what time you go to sleep, and what temperatures you want it to be. And it does it Monday through Friday, Saturday, Sunday. If you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, pick up the phone, give us a call, 516-348-6300, or save time, book online at pipedoc.net. Thanks for watching. Be well, God bless, stay safe.
Hit the like button.